But that's a magic trick. That's a magic trick. Whereas this. I'm not done it yet. Okay. Okay. Oh, uncle. That's a party trick. It is something that you can all just go home and do yourselves with a bit of practice. No secret to how it's done. We'll get a couple more of those later, but we're going to get stuck in with a magic trick for you all. Now, as I said, I've been doing magic since I was 8, and I've noticed that a lot of tricks don't involve everyone. They kind of involve a small group that you're performing to, one or two. It happens to one person, everyone gets to watch. But this next thing is special, because this next thing gets to involve all of you. Every single one of you get to join in. So if you want to join in, play a part in it, take your phones out and go onto your calculators. Lovely. I'll grab a bit of music as well for us, Sid, if you can. Everyone, go onto your calculators. It's more fun than it sounds, I promise. Okay. Thank you very much. Lovely. We're all ready to go. If you've got any music up there, that'd be lovely. But what we're going to do, we're all going to type in the same thing together. We're going to do the same thing together, and we're going to start off by choosing someone at random. So, hello. Would you mind telling us the date and the month of your birthday? Not the year, just the day and the month. 14, so 1404. Everyone type in 1404 into their calculators. 1404. And then hit multiply. Hit multiply. Lovely. Hopefully I haven't lost anyone yet. Okay, let's go. Here, just in the suit on the end, just here. Hello. Sorry, hello. Would you mind telling us your age? 22, everyone type in 22 into their calculators. 22 into their calculators and hit multiply again. Perfect, we should be on 30888. Lovely, and can I check? Here, just on the end, would you mind telling us any time of the day, any hour, minute, but be exact, so hour and minute. 301, everyone type in 301. Perfect, and hit equals. Do we have this number? 9297288. Yeah. All got this? Lovely. Let's press plus. We're gonna press plus. Phil, would you mind just randomly hitting my phone for me, a few numbers? Just kind of, don't even really look, just gonna go crazy. Perfect. Perfect. Lovely. Okay. Everyone, we're going to add this number. Okay. It's a big number. 1773463. That's the final one. So that is 1773463. And hit equals. Do we have this number? 27031920. Yes. If you don't have it, just have a look at the person next to you. Up now. I'm just going to write this down. Okay, so, but most of you have got that, yes? Yeah. Lovely. That is 27031920. That's the number we have. Now, this number, the reason we do it together, by the way, is because usually someone mucks it up along the way. But also to prove to you that this isn't magic so far, it's just maths. Okay, nothing special has happened yet. But this number represents you as a group, as an audience today. Times, dates, and moments brought you to this number right here, right now. And when I say right here, right now, I mean right here, right now, because today is the 27th of the 3rd. That is today's date, the 27th of March. But more than that, 1920. If you look at the exact time on your phones, you'll see it is exactly 1920. Shall we get started with the awards? Yeah. Lovely, thank you very much, thank you. Here we are. I'll let that settle in. I'll let that settle. All right, we have a lot to get through, so we're going to run through. But first of all, I just want to say thank you so much for having me here, to be back again with the Royal Television Society London Centre. And we're celebrating the outstanding entries in 9 categories that were submitted by the universities in the London area. And tonight is full of congratulations. Everyone in this room has been on the crew of a shortlisted film, and you are all very much to be congratulated as you fought off stiff competition. And we must thank the tutors as your who your course executive producers have steered your productions with their honest feedback and given you a taste of the real industry. So here to explain some of the judging process is the executive producer of the awards, Terry Marsh.
Hello, everybody. I've met some of you already. Good evening. I have to take my glasses off. And thank you so much to the Magic Circle for making us so welcome in this historic venue. Their Latin motto, in docilis privati loqui, translates as not apt to disclose secrets. But my job is to make transparent the judging process, which is in line with all of the RTS awards. The different juries for the individual awards are made up of established figures in the industry. They all view their categories, then convene to discuss the entries. After much debate, I have to emphasize that, the entries in each category are reduced to the final three nominations. Then the jury votes by secret ballot to determine the winner. The juries for each category have taken into account levels of budget and extra support some entries have received by building relationships with professionals in various branches of the industry. This means that a small student production team is equally valued as a large team learning the arts of negotiating and working with professional figures and teams. RTS London will be tweeting the winners throughout the ceremony at @RTS_London. So please do retweet. And we have a hashtag as well, don't we, Letitia? #RTS London Awards. Okay. So back to Harry for the main event.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Terry. So we start with the Craft Awards, celebrating excellence in the skills of camera work, editing, sound, production, design, and writing. These are key skills that contribute to the power of storytelling and the emotional experience of the viewer. The winner of these Craft Awards have been selected by the jurors from entries across categories in all categories in this year's competition. We'll go through each craft category, and in turn, for every award, we'll show short clips of the nominated films, as it's important to capture a sense of each of the three finalists. So, first of all, the Camera Work Award.
The nominations for Camera Work are Cat Had His Thumb, Hamish Cairncross, Kingston University.
After speaking with Jess, I wonder where the undigested bone from Jack's thumb was left. By a cat who lived 40 years ago, left to be digested by the same earth Jess dug with her spade. The same earth rabbit's burrows are made from. The same earth trapped in the grooves of a magpie's foot. Earth covered with tarmac to make room for car parks. Earth that spins while phones ring. Earth which feeds lambs which feed people who visit kebab shops. And the same earth my bones and your bones will be left in.
Sime Tutuno, Freddie Logan, University of Westminster.
Thank you. ellos aman su cabello y no se quieren cortar. Varias veces hemos ido y le hemos dicho, oye, ¿no te quieres cortar el cabello? Y yo, no. Y otros por religión. Otros tienen su cultura de religión y no quieren cortarse el cabello.
Normalmente aquí en la sierra, una costumbre también de tenerlo el cabello largo y de no cortarlo porque algunos piensan que el cabello no va a crecer.
Por ahí también las señoras mayores no quieren hacerse cortar porque piensan que ya no les va a crecer, les van a mirar sus vecinas o quizás el esposo les puede enojarles por el machismo que tienen. Por eso no pido por eso.
From the factual category, the jurors recognized a film in which camera work was at once ambitious and intimate. There were effective drone shots and majestic pans across, alongside close and personal interviews that both contributed to, to ensuring a good story told well. And the winner is Freddie Logan, the director of photography, Sydney to Uno, an entry from the University of Westminster.
With your left hand, there's a little pose for the camera. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Freddie. Now we're going to have a look at yes. Let's see another clip.
Nella società non funziona.
Certamente questo territorio oggi è ad un bivio di riscatto a metà tra un passato che lo attanaglia ad un'immobilità e ad una povertà educativa e materiale, ma con una prospettiva di fronte molto, che sì, molto forte.
Congratulations, Freddie. Now, for the editing award.
The nominations for editing are Four Soldiers, Nikita Listopad, London South Bank University.
Это что еще за черт? Все за мной!
Не спеши. Не дай эмоциям затуманить свой разум.
Ты не сам отставь. Подзывай
Что-то толкнуло меня, черт его подери!
Clone, Jack Payne, Global Academy.
Yeah, hey.
See ya.
See ya.
Man 2. Ulayemi Izevbekoi. Monga Maboso. Ayula Samfun. London Metropolitan.
She burnt me with an eye and forced me to sleep on the sofa. Police wouldn't believe me if I reported her.
She burnt me with...
managed to call 999 before
glass.
She isolated me from...
Domestic abuse is often portrayed as a gendered crime, perpetrated by men against women. But many men suffer physical, emotional, sexual and financial abuse from their intimate partners. Through the lens of these survivors, we are exposed to the complex and disturbing realities of men in the hands of their abusers and the remarkable journeys they undertake to rebuild their lives.
The jury agreed that this winning film was expertly edited to give pace, intrigue, and an authentic horror mystery genre atmosphere, with a world of fractures and flashbacks evoking the trauma of battle-weary soldiers. The winner is Nikita Listopad, editor of Four Soldiers, London South Bank University. Let's see another clip.
Ты должен это сделать, Том. Пойми, оно проникает в самые глубины нашего подсознания. Видит все наши страхи.
Стоп, Дэй! Стоп!
Питается нашей ненавистью. Я уже заражен им. Когда-то у меня отняли все. Но сейчас я не позволю ему забрать и тебя моими же руками. Ты еще можешь прожить достойную жизнь.
Congratulations, Nikita. And now we come to the Craft Award for Sound Design.
The nominations for sound are Crush, Rujang Liao, London College of Communication, University of the Arts, London. Mind, Miles McAllister, University of Westminster. The Other Half, Max Hayes, Oscar Pelayez, Jen Sigsworth, Middlesex University.
Your moustache, more like your eyebrows came down for a drink.
Oh, Mary, that's good.
That was great. Wait.
I knew that cake would come in handy.
The striking soundscape portrayed in our winning film was described by our jurors as simply beautiful. It creatively captured the kaleidoscope of images, at once dramatic and comedic, with a great use of music and natural sounds. The award goes to Ruzhang Liao for Crush from the London College of Communication, University of the Arts. Ruzhang is unable to be here tonight, so instead her tutor, Su Ling Tan.
So Matt, this is for you. Oh. There we go, lovely, there you go. This is. And Darren, was it?
And Darren.
Thank you.
So let's see another clip. The next craft award is for production design. The skill of production, very popular, the skill of production design covers a wide range, from prop sourcing and placement to research and set building, all setting the scene and the tone of the story. Let's have a look.
The nominations for production design are Fortune Favors the Fantabulous, Phoebe Baker, David Komet, University of Westminster.
Unimaginable forces of evil and terror will conspire against you, but you mustn't let them win. No, you must take what is yours. You must...
I don't think it's working. Sorry, did I do something wrong?
No, it's not your fault. Magic here isn't as strong as it once was.
Oh. Do you think there's a chance it could, I don't know, come back?
One can dream.
Right. Well, see ya.
May fortune follow your every footstep.
Mind, Illyrian Samai, University of Westminster.
Help me!
Trail fades. Clara Dobrentie, London South Bank University.
Ez a sok furcsa démoni alak...
Elnézést, nem éppen egy szép darab. Hogy mondhat ilyet? Az ilyesmit nem lehet csupán ennyivel elintézni.
Maga festette?
Nem, én ehhez nem értek. Azt kérem egyértelmű. Mondják csak, ennek a gyereknek mi baja van?
Ha nem kell vele foglalkozni, farkasok nevelték föl.
Hogy mondja?
Farkasok. A művészet nem a legjobb üzlet a világon. De mondja, ez hogy kerül ide?
És nem veszélyes az ilyen?
Nem minden az üzlet a világon. Vannak annál sokkal fontosabb dolgok.
Na, és mi lenne az?
The winner invited us to step into a fantastical world where the very set became a character of cheap jokes and blowing raspberry noises. The designers really did pull something out of a hat. The winners are Phoebe Baker and David Kinnett. And fortune favours the fantabulous, the University of Westminster.
Congratulations.
Let's see another clip. Highlighted the technical skills, but we still have one more craft to recognize, writing. In their deliberations, the different juries talked at length about the importance of structure and making the story clear, as your viewer is seeing your film for the first time. Let's have a look at the nominations.
The nominations for writing are Sime Totuno, Alice Franchi, Alice Sacco, University of Westminster.
Scampia è un quartiere dell'area nord di Napoli, ideato negli anni 60 con un'ideale città popolare autosufficiente. I grandi progetti e le promesse iniziali, però, col tempo vengono meno e Scampia si trasforma così in uno dei molti quartieri dormitorio del paese. Anno dopo anno, i tassi di disoccupazione e abbandono scolastico crescono e l'infiltrazione mafiosa della Camorra attrae riflettori su un'area che diventa così oggetto di giudizio e pregiudizio della cronaca nazionale e internazionale. Ma guardando più a fondo, si scopre la storia di un quartiere che, generazione dopo generazione, lotta per riscrivere il proprio destino tramite il lavoro di una comunità unita nel desiderio di dare ai giovani di Scampia i mezzi e la libertà di essere autori del proprio futuro.
Sola, Claudia Orioles, Ravensbourne University, London.
Dime, hija.
Mamá, llego a las 4. ¿Estás lista?
No.
¿Qué pasa?
No encuentro la caja.
¿Pero cómo puede ser? A ver, ¿dónde pintaste la última vez? ¿En la cocina, el comedor, no sé?
No lo recuerdo. Philip decía que siempre la dejaba por el medio y molestaba.
¿Y no la habrá guardado Philip en algún lado? No te pongas nerviosa. Cuando llegue, subo y la buscamos.
No.
Pero si juntas la encontramos antes, ya verás. A las 4 estoy allí. No estás sola, ¿vale?
The Turning Point. Sanaa Hamdoun, Middlesex University.
من بعد ما صارت هيدي الأوضاع الاقتصادية اللي أثرت علينا بطريقة جدا سلبية، فاللي صار إنه نحن خلص راحوا مصرياتنا وما بقى يعني ما بقى اشتغل بابا فطلعوه من البنك وهيك. لما صارت قصة كورونا قعدنا كلياتنا بالبيوت، صح لي إني أنزل مع رفيقتي كنت عم بتناقش أنا وياها كثير بخصوص التصوير وهيك، فقالت لي إنه ريان بكرة عندي تصوير، قلت لها كثير عبالي أنا أنزل معك. بتذكر كان هيدا الدات 20/6/2020. كان بالفعل نهار سعادتي، كان مثل تيرنينج بوينت لإلي، لأنه قلبني من شخص مثل كأنه ماشي بالشي اللي مش هو بده إياه، العالم اللي بده إياهن ونظرة المجتمع هن شو بدهن، لشي أنا بدي إياه بغض النظر إذا حبوه ولا ما حبوه، اللي هو قصة التصوير والتعب وهيدا الشغل كلياته.
This last craft award proved to be a tough, close call, with much debate from the very strong drama category of 29 entries this year. The winner director delivers a three-act narrative, some heartfelt dialogue with a gentle twist at the end. The craft award for writing goes to Claudia Orellos for Sola from Ravenbourne University, London. Let's see another clip.
Felipe está en casa. Le he dicho que iba a sacar la basura. Toma.
Con esto ya lo tienes todo, ¿no?
No.
¿Cómo que no? No. ¿Por qué no nos vamos ya? ¿Qué te falta?
Es que no encuentro la caja de pinturas.
Bueno, mujer, mañana compramos otra. Vámonos, no. Por favor.
Esa caja era de mi madre, de tu abuela. No me puedo marchar sin ella.
Mamá. ¿Estás segura? Mañana me pongo aquí a las 4.
Sí.
A las 4.
Sí.
Mañana. Te quiero, mamá. Eres fuerte.
Congratulations, Claudia. We are about halfway through the night, so what do you say to a bit more magic? That was half of you, that was. Should we go again? What do you say for a bit more magic? There we go. All right, a couple of magic tricks, a couple of party tricks. Oh, the party tricks, by the way. I'm aware that some of you might be thinking, do I cheat? Put a yes from down here. Do I cheat at these party tricks? Well, how is this for an answer? No, I wouldn't dream. Wouldn't dream of it. No. Some of the party tricks are things that actually you could just do yourself. This next one you can try because it. Well, I would advise you not trying it. It is dangerous. don't try it at home. But all it uses is some cocoa powder. Just uses some cocoa powder. Because it has milk powder in it, and when milk powder is a dust form, it has a very interesting property, which is, I'll show you. Uh-huh. I'm moving on. Uh-huh. Ha 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 ha!
And that is how you make hot chocolate. It's worth it for that joke. Don't try that at home, by the way. That is dangerous. That is dangerous. And I'm a trained professional. By trained, I mean I've done it more than you. And by professional, I have no other source of income. So, right. Now, I want to show you something. Is it anyone's first time seeing magic here tonight? Anyone's first time ever seeing magic live? I'm going to do some close-up magic downstairs later for you as well when you're having your drinks. Is anyone's first time ever seeing magic in person? Maybe one or two at the back, maybe? The reason I ask is it's kind of lovely to know that I might be that person for you seeing magic, because the first time that I saw magic, and any magician, that is moment is unforgettable. It's really unforgettable. For me, it was a man called Colonel Custard. He's like a local kids entertainer. I met him at the greatest place on earth. It was called Lucas World of Furniture. It was like a local IKEA. It was a showroom that sold kitchens and bathrooms and sofas. And it was a place for all the family. We would all go there every weekend. Because for the mums, they would go around choosing what color sofas and cupboards and cabinets and stuff they would have. But for the kids, there was a creche area, and in the creche was the Colonel, along with a face painter and a balloon modeler and that kind of stuff. But Colonel Custard was there. And for the dads, walking around serving champagne and orange juice were these ladies wearing very short skirts. I'm aware times have changed. And I'm not saying my dad's a pervert, but we had 13 sofas. Now, but the magician, the Colonel that I saw, that feeling of seeing him, that feeling of wonder was unforgettable, and it made me want to become a magician. But the weird thing about that is the more you learn magic, the more you study it, the less you experience that feeling, the less you're fooled. So then you have to start looking elsewhere to experience real magic. Science, nature, technology, and that kind of stuff. And there's real magic right in our pockets on our phones. I don't know how they work. A couple of taps and food arrives at my door. A couple of swipes, I'm on a date. A tap and a swipe, I'm on a date with the Deliveroo driver. So, but there's one particular app I think is incredibly magical. It's called Akinator, or 20 Questions. You know, when you think of a celebrity and tries to guess who you're thinking of in 20 questions, that kind of thing? I'm trying to learn that. I'm trying to become the human 20 questions machine. I can borrow this for a second. Tonight, I'd like to play with one of you. So I see you just there in your sparkly dress. Would you mind helping out? And you can stay where you are. Okay. But would you just take the microphone? Sure. Is that all right? Would you play along? Yeah?
Yeah, perfect. Absolutely.
Would you say your name into the microphone for
it's
me?
It's Kirsten.
Kirsten, good lovely evening. Stuff. Thank you very much, Kirsten. Kirsten, I'd like to think of a celebrity icon character to someone we'd all know and recognise. Get someone into your head. Whilst Kirsten does this, I'll explain to you how it works. It's a memory thing. I've got to have a sort of a database memory of thousands of celebrities, characters, icons, and throughout history. Then thousands of questions, and they flow chart down until I'm hopefully left with one person. Do you have one person in mind?
I do.
You do, lovely. Yes. I'm going to ask you up to 20 questions. But would you mind keeping track of how many questions, just on your fingers and your toes, how many questions I ask? It won't be more than 20. But if you don't know the answer, just say you don't know, but ideally yes or no answers. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't count. Okay, that doesn't count. Okay, let's start. Is there any music at all? No worries at all? We're just going to rattle through this. Let's go with number... That wasn't a question either. Okay, this is for you. Let's go for... Are they male?
Yes.
Yes. Are they American?
No.
No. Are they English?
Yes.
Yes. Are they a musician?
No.
No.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
A little.
But it's not their primary thing?
No.
Okay. Let's go for, are they also a sports person?
You could say. Yes.
Are they an actor?
Yes.
Yes. Are they are they a character?
Character, yes.
They're a character. Oh, okay. So they okay. it gets tricky here. Are they over 30?
Now possibly.
The character or
character wasn't. Oh, I'm confusing you.
It's okay. are they in action films?
No.
Okay, no. Are they in a series? Are you playing along, by the way? You can sort of play along and track it through. Are they in a series of films?
Yes.
Yes. Are they? Do they have an iconic prop? Do they have an iconic prop they hold or
Yes.
Yes? Okay. Let's go. Are they... How many questions are we on? Okay, that's good. Are they... So they wear something iconic as well. You could recognise them by something they would wear?
Yes.
You could? Okay, lovely. You said they're not over 30. Is the... do they... Are they an Avenger?
As in the Avengers characters?
Yeah,
as in the Marvel?
Yes.
No.
Do they have a power?
Oh, yes.
Is it set in space?
No.
Don't say it yet. I have who I think you're thinking of. Can I get a clipboard for me? I have who I think you're thinking of. Don't say it just yet.
I hope I haven't confused you.
No, it's okay. I'm going to guess based on your answers so far. Don't say who it is. All I need for this is a glue stick and about 30 seconds of your time. So, I'm going to go for this, but I'm aware that I may be off. I'm going to go for based purely on a couple of factors of me being on stage. I think you're going to go for this person. Dead or alive? Oh, are they alive?
Yes.
Okay. It's too late now. Yeah, just draw you a nice picture. Okay. For the first time, can you name the person you're thinking of?
You want me to say the name?
Sure.
Harry Potter.
Harry Potter? Please, welcome to the stage.
Fantastic.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I'll take the microphone. Thank you so much. Thank you. It's tricky. That was a tricky one. Oh, it smells lovely. I said I based it on a little bit on what people think of when I'm up here, because I'm aware my name is Harry. I'm a British magician that wears glasses. I'm aware of that. And so that's usually, and I sleep under the stairs. No, I'm kidding. I live in London, I can't afford a place with stairs. Now, okay, we move on to the final half of the evening, and we move on to the main category awards, and they are the genres of animation, comedy, and entertainment, factual, and drama. Our first, give it a whoop for those. There we go. Our first award is for animation. This category includes films of any style or subject matter, and the judges look for technical competence, originality, and the ability of the animation to enhance the way a story can be told or a message conveyed. The animation category always attracts great talent, and 2024 is no exception, with the jurors commenting on the maturity of technical skill. The jury arrived at three finalists. So, here are the nominations for the animation category.
The nominations for animation are Crush, Rujang Liao, London College of Communication, University of the Arts, London. deeper still. Max Callaby, Kingston University. Mind, Illyrian Samai, University of Westminster.
The winner, please welcome from the animation jury, Kristen Mason.
Firstly, thank you to my fellow jury members, Sean Collins, Jamie Floodgate, Gloria Gaminagi, I'm so sorry if I've spotted your name wrong, said your name wrong, Lynn Hood, Dean Stockton, and John Whittington. We were pleased to see an increased number of entries from last year, and again, each one was in very different in subject matter. We all enjoyed the use of mixed media and marvelled at the level of ambition coupled with amazing budgetary restraint. In fact, all but one of the entries were produced for under £100. Firstly, Deeper Still immediately generated words like charming and delightful and even blown away from our jury, and more than one of our animation experts commented on its instant commercial appeal. The story is set in a mineshaft with two characters communicating through noises and gestures rather than speech. The colourful set of glinting rocks and dazzling jewels evokes something of a fairy tale quality and easily engages the attention of the viewer. There was some debate about tightening up the editing, but there was also praise for the time taken to capture little moments like fingertips tapping on the shoulder and brushing a seat. Overall, it was felt that the stop animation with felt and fibre figures was executed well with its simple range of eyebrow movements and mouth shapes, and the jury debate ended with unanimous acclaim that this is a film with heart. such as the ethereal dazzle of sound and shapes, that more than one juror felt that in Crush, the narrative wasn't immediately obvious on first viewing. It's a love story about the gravitational attraction between the moon and the earth that is so strong that the two bodies make kiss contact. A moment praised especially by one juror for an optical flare coupled with other grainy lighting effects. The ever-increasing destruction of the gravitational effects and the comedy of floating sheep and fish was thought to be excellent, as was capturing the nature of water. A mesmerizing 8 minutes, thought one juror. The technical skill of rotating bodies kept in differing perspectives was noted, as was the mixture of synthetic violin and natural noises, soundscapes. The final collective juror comments range from dreamlike to very evocative and ambitious to the piano moments had something of a Japanese animation vibe. The third nomination is Mind, which is a very atmospheric stop motion 2D and live action mix, and with a set design at a very professional level. It tells the story of a young, traumatized patient in recovery at an old style holiday home. First impressions from the jurors were a piece well crafted, with more than one immediately picking up on the lighting, building suspense and foreboding. As with every jury on every category, the debate is balanced and robust. One juror in this instance, a little disappointed at the lack of twist in the tale, another liking its open-endedness. There was unanimous praise for the textures achieved on the characters' faces, but also some comments about jerky movements from one moment to the next. Or are these fragment flashes of a nightmare experience? The debate finished with praise for the audio being nicely balanced and working well to achieve its aims. Such was the standard of animation entries that the final voting went to a tie, and then to a casting vote, so very, very close. But I can now announce that the winner of the animation category is Mind by Illyrian Pitsamai from the University of Westminster.
Yes. Let's see a further clip of the winning entry. Congratulations once again. Now we are moving on to the entertainment and comedy drama category. There were more entries in this category than last year, but once again we see that this is an arguably most difficult category, as entertainment and laughs often depend on personal taste. A happy conjunction of script, situation and performance is vital, and any weakness in any of those areas is plain to see. Judges look for technical excellence, humour and, where appropriate, pace, audience interest and engagement. The three nominations are
The nominations for entertainment and comedy drama are Ataraxia, Andrea Peroni, Samuel Levy, King's College London.
Thank you.
Fortune favors the fantabulous. Emmanuel Lee, Anna Ungurianu, Michael O'Brien Doran, University of Westminster.
Put your hands on the ball and close your eyes. Hey, it's all right. I want you to think of your sister and all the places she could be. This ball will help clear your mind and lead you on the right path. Anything coming to you?
There's this beach house that we used to go to as kids. I haven't been since I was 5, but I know she'd go there if she found things difficult.
Good. Very good, Miss Vosh. I cannot guarantee that your sister is there. The vision is hazy. However, my intuition does tell me that your sister, if you do meet again, will be willing to forgive you. If you are willing to be open to her, no matter what you may have said. Miss Vosh, grab the tablecloth. Just do it. Clearly the ancient powers smile upon you tonight, Miss Vosh.
The other half. Alina Eileen, Benjamin Bogdan Hodgson, Middlesex University.
Morning.
Oh, good morning. I'm Ash. I'll be delivering your post.
Sorry about that. I was finishing up my painting.
Oh, You paint?
Yeah. Wait.
Beautiful. About time we had an artist in town.
I'm Nadia. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. I almost forgot. This is, this is for you.
Thank you.
See you around.
See you.
To announce the winner, here from the Entertainment and Comedy Drama Jury is Kirsten Caron. Oh.
Thank you, Harry. Still can't get over Harry Potter. Good evening, all. It is my privilege to be here to present for this award. Thank you to my fellow jury members, Kevin Bishop, Anne Cohen, and Leslie Scarf. And we enjoyed viewing all the entries immensely. As Harry said, this can be a particularly tricky category, diverse and eclectic. It gave us, the jury, plenty to deliberate, and each entry exploited the three great comedy disciplines of writing, timing, and visuals with varying degrees of success and ambition. First, we come to the other half. This had the highest budget of all the category entries, ingeniously raised through crowdfunding, pub events, and even bake sales, All of which demonstrates the team passion and the producer's sense to make this project succeed. It was felt that money was well spent on a gorgeous chocolate box European village location. Indeed, we certainly felt that the film had a feel of chocolat, and its setting and in its cinematography, wonderful. It's a romantic comedy with themes of diversity, inclusion, and conformity through the metaphors of all the villagers, whether male, female, or even the children wearing comedy moustaches. The film gets off to a confident start with a beautiful swooping shot into the picturesque village high street to pick up on what becomes an extremely strong performance from the lead, the Super Mario-looking postman character whose comic timing was absolutely excellent. After being love-struck, the sped-up sequence with his cutaways backwards and forth and with the character's super ability to post bags of letters is an absolute gem, very witty. The pace and the placement of the scenes is well judged, and there is a discernible beginning, middle, and end to the story, with the large cast striving to be as entertaining and funny as possible. The jurors picked up on the use of natural light and the adept use of backlighting and moonlight in particular. I particularly love that, and building the atmosphere and the moods. As one juror put it, we concur as well. I watched the whole thing through with a smile on my face. Constructively, it would be noted that for such an ambitious project, there was academic support and guidance, but no professional industry help. So, we come on to ataraxia. A state of freedom from emotional disturbance, especially as an ongoing condition of soul-fulfilling entertainment. That's something we could all use right about now. The film can best be described as a piece of whimsy. When a homeless man makes use of a Boris bike and finds happiness pedaling around the streets of London, it gives him freedom from what is otherwise a sedentary and dull existence. The choice of black and white film evokes the drabness of the urban environment as perceived through the eyes of the homeless man. It was shot on a tiny budget with two borrowed cameras and a mobile phone around the environs of Waterloo, where thousands of people pass this man every day. The jurors agreed that this film is nice and simple, a good watch, well framed, and composed well. It really was imaginative in its use of music also. The fast, frenetic jazz score of sheer joyful abandonment, contrasting with what I particularly loved, the Chaplin-esque pathos of losing his bike and the grandeur of the serene classical waltz as he continues his day on another bike. At the end, he is so exhilarated, he doesn't know whether to laugh or cry. Constructively, it was felt that there were some issues with the balance of the sound, and one juror particularly felt that perhaps a feedback or flashback sequence would have helped in explaining the origins of the homeless man's passion for his love of cycling, and for the viewer, I think, to be able to share perhaps in his nostalgia. Overall, though, the piece romps along, leaving us with a warm, fuzzy feeling of fun, and it's a little story told very well. Finally, in this category, the universe of fortune favors the fantabulous. And what a great portmanteau that is. It's situated with a small circus tent that stands alone in a desolate field, battered by winds during the day and terrifying thunderstorms at night, where Fei Lu, a young Cantonese British would-be mystic, battles with the banality of local bureaucracy. You can tell that the group gathers, the prop gathers, and the dressers have been hard at work here decorating this fortune teller's tent, whilst Faye feeds all at once and feels powerful and fragile. The sidekick sister, Steph, helps with some dodgy tricks and illusions, passing some notes under the table, shaking the crystal ball under the table. There are some great moments of special effects here. I especially liked the smoke and mirrors, as did the other jurors, and the cheeky confetti to make the magic moments sparkle. Perhaps the greatest trick of all for the whole inside emporium was to vanish, as if by magic, the following morning as the council eviction squad descends and moves in. The strong cast all rise to the occasion, from the comedy duo council officers to the utterly gullible clientele. And there's a well-portrayed strong bond between Faye and his sister as they discuss the backstory of Faye being disowned by their parents and for the choice of lifestyle and wanting to break free. Constructively, it was generally felt that a tightening of pace at some moments would have been helpful, and there was one instance of eye line between characters slightly crossing. More than one juror, though, commented on the high level of grading and the contrast between the carnival colours of Faye's earthly surroundings and the greys and blacks of his dream and nightmare worlds. So high was the bar for this year's category and the entries that we, the jury, wanted to make a special commendation for Clone, a project that didn't make the final three, but was nevertheless praised for the witty script, manic pace, and original idea, the whole production being the epitome of a one-man band approach by Jack Payne. So well done to you, Jack. Now I have the pleasure of announcing the winning entry for the entertainment and comedy drama category. And it is The Other Half. Alina Illin, Benjamin Bogdan Hobden, Middlesex University.
Let's have another look at the winning entry.
You are incredibly creative. Just look at the way you deliver your post.
I do the same thing with birthday cards, pensions,
yeah,
and parcels.
I love letters.
Yeah. Those two.
They must be kidding me.
Oh, wait, Nadia, we should think this through. What do you think of this?
Congratulations again to the Other Half dynamic duo of Alina and Benjamin and their team. Onwards to our next category, factual. For the first time, RTS have split the entries into long-form factual and short-form factual. These categories offered an access into a variety of worlds, from men suffering domestic violence and body image across generations to London life as a drag artist and wig making in Peru. We start with factual long form with two nominations.
The nominations for factual long form are Sime Tutuno, Alice Frenchie, Yasmin Boxall, Freddie Logan, University of Westminster.
Chiromecchino nasce nel 2002 con l'idea di prendere parte ai processi politici, sociali, culturali che si svolgono in quel periodo in città. Nel corso dei 20 anni e più di attività noi abbiamo potuto constatare sulla vita delle persone che abbiamo incontrato che la volontà educativa si eredita e si amplifica di generazione in generazione. Quelli che noi oggi incontriamo sono i figli, i genitori con i quali io ho cominciato le attività più di 20 anni fa. E purtroppo i ragazzi e le ragazze, i bambini e le bambine che incontriamo oggi sono figli di quella povertà educativa e ne portano addosso tutto il peso. Vivere all'interno di una casa popolare dove le pareti sono di cartone e dove piove in casa significa non avere accesso ad un'esistenza dignitosa. E questo, se avviene per più generazioni, significa che tu stai costruendo un pezzo di paese sul quale tu non stai investendo.
Some Hairs Never Fall. Romina Osterling, Luke Reed, Lucy Gidley, Alison Bevan, London South Bank University.
Se remonta a cuando recién tuve alopecia, a los 18 años. Y yo en verdad no la entendía. Se me cayó bastante pelo y no entendía qué me pasaba. Mi pelo también se había puesto débil, un poco opaco, de otro color incluso. Y empecé a ir a dermatólogos, doctores de hormonas también. Tomé pastillas que me quemaban el hígado. Me hice tratamientos como el PRP. No sirvió de nada. Y como 8 años después, recién tuve un doctor que me dijo, lo que tú tienes es alopecia androgenética, es una condición autoinmune, no tiene cura, así se va a quedar tu pelo, no lo vas a recuperar. Entré en una depresión donde me engordé como 10, 15 kilos. Era mi primer año de universidad y no salía a ningún lado, no tenía amigos, no me sentía feliz conmigo misma y mi autoestima estaba en el suelo.
To discuss the nominations in both forms is jury producer Duncan McAlpine.
Thank you, Harry. It's so great to see you all here this evening. It's absolutely wonderful. Thank you so much. Thank you too to the jury members. That's Robert Sita, Samira Abidabro, Chris Jurgensen, Shelley Talton, and Lucy Sandys Winch. The standard of factual entries this year shows much evidence of ambition and access, which is sometimes very difficult to achieve on your budgets. The entries in this category this year triggered some interesting discussions between our jurors, and all were truly engaged. Firstly, to long-form factual and Sime Tutuno, which shines a light on the village of Scampia in a notoriously poor agricultural province near Naples. The opening slow pan across the high-rise blocks of 1960s flats, grubby and dirty with disrepair, sets the tone of dull despondency. This contrasted with brightly clothed and energetic people organizing social clubs, peaceful marches, and street festivals to encourage pride and opportunity in their village. Through a series of interviews, we learn the origins of Scampia and why it has become the birthplace of all troubles. Elderly Mireia perceptively points out that television depictions of the mafia-infiltrated area reinforce how the young people regard themselves, and Mario confesses he felt ashamed to say he came from Scampia. Barbara Piero explains how, more than 20 years ago, when the local government failed to invest, a social project was launched. People's ability to network and collaborate pooled the many and various potentials of residents to celebrate cultural differences between the Italians and the Roma community. This has made Scampia a vanguard of social innovation compared to other districts of Napoli. Some excellent drone coverage shows the sprawling shanty town areas over which the step pyramid of the central housing block dominates. One telling shot shows an elevated motorway crammed with speeding cars just passing by the village in complete ignorance. Another GoPro travelling car shot shows endless banks of rubbish building up on the side of the road. One of the great success stories is the drama club that allows young people to compare city and urban life, richer and poorer neighbourhoods. The filmmakers gained trust and access that delivered honest and open sound bites and opinions. The loudest voice comes from the people in the form of graffiti writ large on the concrete. We are not the problem, and this is not a zoo. The slow motion carnival sequence towards the end is a joy to watch, capturing the unbridled expression that there are possibilities in the future, at least for that one day. Being transported to another world is very much the forefront of Some Hairs Never Fall. This is the story of a group of seven female wig makers in the highlands of Peru who find purpose and empowerment within their world of threat and domestic abuse. This domestic violence, mostly a result of excessive drinking, is brought sharply into focus by the testimony of two young children who talk on camera very openly, very movingly. And this is obviously the result of careful and considerate management by the filmmakers. One woman hits upon the idea of wig making from her own need of a wig owing to the onset of alopecia when she was just 18. She realized that there is an abundance of raw material. Women in Peru grow their hair long for religious or self-image reasons, and sometimes won't cut their hair because, get this, their husbands are going to get mad. The excitement of wig making shines through. The women are fascinated by the delicacy, the tools and the stitching, and the pleasure that they derive in their progress. One of the women has to leave when her husband complains, and there is sadness, but defiance in a group shot of determined faces accompanied by a score of rising modern electric guitar music. The gentle crossfade editing shows how much the women enjoy their group sessions, which help them de-stress and start talking about how to help women, not just in Peru, but all over the world. While it was felt by some jurors that the material would benefit from more rigorous storyboarding and tightening, they were full of praise for the beautiful camera work and the uplifting sense of purpose and achievement by these entrepreneurial women. So, it was a difficult choice to make, and it went to a split decision with a casting vote. But the winner is Some Hairs Never Fail. Please welcome to the stage Romina Osterling, Luke Reed, London South Bank University. Let's have another look, another clip from the winning entry.
Yo ahorita prácticamente soy ama de casa y también, bueno, el trabajo, ¿no? En mi caso es un poco tedioso porque el papá de mis hijos trabaja en lo que es construcción y, bueno, pues también va el trabajo, pero también va la bebida alcohólica. En sí se dedica a tomar, se pone a tomar y pues llega así a la casa. A veces hay días que no se viene y siempre nos pasa ese tipo de problemas. No quiero que mis hijos vean que se ponga a tomar.
Congratulations again to Romina and Luke.
And so on to the short form factual nominations.
The nominations for factual short form are Ambarkborg Vior, the living doll, Katie McGallicott Ryan, Tara McNamee, University of Westminster.
The doll named Dawn as a character is like a big middle finger, I guess, to Ireland in a way. She was made of the ashes of like an Ireland that kind of says that you can only look and act and survive if you are in one certain kind of person. She's made me ask myself a lot of questions about like, not just about like my work as like a drag artist, but like what does it mean to me that I'm doing something that is like based very much in history? And like how do we like combat this like machine of drag, I guess, like this drag machine that is kind of as a result of things like Drag Race. I think Tá Nóir Éireann, like with Mar Éireannaigh, and Tá Nóir Éireann Rib Ruddy a Tá Difriúil, and a Tá Scanrúil, like a piece of beag, like Ruddy Nua, Tá Agla Éireann Rib Ruddy Nua, and I think size by hook or by crook, Mar an Vábhóg, Déanam Ruddy in a Will Scanrúil, agus a Will Nua, agus a Will Nóirach, but it's kind of like exposure therapy.
The Turning Point. Sanaa Hamdoun, Middlesex University.
انفجار بيروت يلي كان نقطة تحول جدا كبيرة بحياتي. بهيدا النهار هو الانفجار شي كتير كان كبير، منه شي انه والله انفجار عادي او هيك، لا وصل للعالم كله. يعني نحن حتى هون بالجي من بيروت لهون سمعناه، رجت البناية كلها. طب لحظتها حملت كاميرتي مثل ما هي والشنطة وهيك ودغري نزلت على بيروت. لما نزلت وشفت الدمار الموجود هون لقيت بروبس موجودين خاصهم مثلا بالانسان. لقيت ساعة سوداء كان واقفة على الوقت اللي صار فيه الانفجار على الساعة 6 و7 دقايق. شفتها صورتها بين كل الدمار اللي كان موجود. في برداية مصوريتها وهيك البيت كلياته مدمر بتذكر، ومن ورا مبين اسود، يعني كأنه عن جد مات شيء اللي جوات البيت. بس شفت شغلة كتير عنتني، أنا وعم صور شفت مثل إزازة راسمة خريطة لبنان مكسرة من الأربع جهات. أنا وعم صورها حسيت إنه هيدي الإزازة يلي دمرت بالأساس لبنان.
Please welcome back to the stage Duncan.
Whisperers, Alexandra Golas, Edvin Setakowski, Juliana Persson, Tina Carlotta, Christina Georgiou, London College of Communication, University of the Arts, London.
Dużo jeszcze chodzić będziesz. Nie pierwsza taka twoja podróż.
I tak wygląda nasza natura, tak wygląda nasze życie. Mamy wpisane w to i śmierć narodziny, i obfitość, i ubóstwo, i dzień, i noc. I taki jest cykl, i to jest harmonia. I wtedy się wszystko układa.
Szeptuchy ewoluują, jak całe życie, jak cały świat, to wszystko się zmienia. Ta zmienność jest cudowna. Jeżeli ktoś nie widzi piękna w tej zmienności, to lepiej niech szybciej to zobaczy, bo to już się na naszych oczach zmienia. Właściwie już teraz szeptuchy odchodzą. Te stare pokolenia, które tutaj na Podlasiu są, to już są babcie, które mają 80-90 lat, już nieraz gorzej się czują, nie zawsze przyjmują. I właściwie na moich oczach, na naszych oczach ten świat odchodzi, szeptuch.
You won't expect this. Please welcome back to the stage, Duncan.
The first of our finalists, Anne Barbog Bayo, the living doll, is a fun, messy and very characterful account of life as a trans drag artist in London for someone with an Irish Catholic upbringing. Danielle James is immediately portrayed with Black and White Archive as coming from a culture which is from another time and space, stuck in religious strictures, whilst her life as a drag artist is loud and fast and colourful. She switches back and forth in Gaelic and English to show her heritage from both cultures. She speaks very candidly and openly about being bullied for being trans from the age of 14 or so. She's clearly relaxed in front of the filmmakers, which is to their credit. When Danielle is in full living doll mode as Dolly, the production design is unashamedly pink and glorious, ironically celebrating that color. Danielle explains that she wants to take the art of drag to interesting and extreme lengths and describes herself as a drag terrorist, where the drag act is eye-catching and different. She lip-syncs to Sade's smooth operator and shaves her leg and armpit hair, a performance as playful and funny as it is thought-provoking. Danielle leaves us with the idea that too many Irish people, newness and self-expression are in fact scary, so her version of drag artistry is like exposure therapy. The jury thought that she and her passions are very much in the now. From single person subject to another, the turning point is a story of determination to break into the film industry. Rayan Al-Haj is a young Lebanese woman who was obsessed with drawing from an early age, but her parents discouraged her passions, preferring a more stable career in banking following her father. In a series of well-constructed chapters of storytelling, the film starts boldly with a half dozen people expressing their hopes and dreams of a career, when life was interrupted spectacularly by the Port of Beirut explosion that caused over 200 deaths, 7,000 injuries, and left 30,000 homeless. It was a day that transformed Rayan from doing what others wanted into what she wanted to do, regardless of any disapproval from society. That day, she grabbed her stills camera to get as close as she dared to the devastation. She captures images like a single dead bird, a flapping torn curtain, a black watch in the debris stuck on the exact time of the explosion, and a hole in a thick pane of glass that resembles the outline of Lebanon itself. In the third act, she applies to Lebanon University and is rejected, crying, she says, for the next 5 months. The clear story arc continues with college years, another failed application, and finally achieving the third highest marks in the country. In the final act, Rayan is as pleased as punch to show us her room at the university. While the jurors felt that it would have been good to see some of Rayan's portfolio in the film, the story is well told, crisply edited, and gives her every chance to show her determination and joy, a clarion call to all filmmakers here tonight. The film is neatly bookended with the interviewees at the beginning, none of whom sadly achieved their dream. And finally, Whisperers. In the best tradition of investigative journalism, this short film opens up a window on a disappearing world. For hundreds of years in a rural part of Poland, women with shamanic powers have brought their gifts of healing to the community. Elzbieta and Cora are amongst the last of the Whisperers as their kind gradually dies out, as it seems there are no younger people coming through. The film starts strongly with an incantation song by one of the healer women. The jurors thought that it was well shot and well paced to the point of gentle elegance, connecting the outside natural world to the inside domestic. However, some commented that it was a shame that recipients of the treatments and spells did not have a voice. Others thought that the fact that we don't even see their faces accentuated the privilege of being present in these private moments. At the midpoint of the film, it is made clear that the Whisperers enable an environment where both healer and recipient have hope and must believe in a cure. Both Elizabetta and Cora come across as very humble, ordinary people who don't even like to be called Whisperers. There was a comment that investment in a sturdy tripod would tighten and tidy up, but others argued that the handheld effect gives the film an intimacy and an immediacy, as if we are all present throughout. There is an elegiac sense at the end, as the modern community's connection to nature diminishes. Will the practice of whispering survive? So this was another very difficult jury decision, and by process of gradual elimination, I'm very proud to say the winner is The Turning Point. Please welcome to stage Sanaa Hamdoun from Middlesex University. Well done. Well done.
Let's have another clip from the winning entry.
درست خلصت اخذت تي اس ان لما نجحت بالمعهد قلت كمان سنة الجاي لما يرجع يفتحوا مجال باللبنانية حارجع اقدم سلت ثاني مره كمان لما عم بقدم على الجامعه كمان طلعت ويتنج ليست هالمره اوكي كملت اخذت تي اس 2 وقت تخرجت السنه من المعهد طلعت الثالثه على لبنان فمن بعدها رجعت قدمت ثالث مرة على اللبنانية مصرة كنت بعدني على الموضوع وهين هلأ طلعت الرابعة بالليستا وهلأ أنا صرت طالبة اللبنانية بالسينما فهيدا الشيء اللي أنا كان بدي إياه ليقدر يفتح لي طريق أني أوصل لكون سينماتوغرافر لأنه بالجامعة اللبنانية بيعلموا بالماستر السينماتوغرافي
Congratulations once again. And now to the drama category. Once again, as in other years, the range and quality of the entries in the drama category were particularly impressive. The jurors felt that the subjects were imaginatively handled by the creators, but cautioned that the writers would always keep in mind that your audiences will see your work for the very first and perhaps the only time. So keep your story clear. Let's look at the nominations.
The nominations for drama are Picturesque, Will Hextall, Harry Norton, Ellie Woolwork, London Metropolitan University.
You okay?
Close your eyes.
I know you're looking.
What? How else are you going to know if you put it all back to front?
The table.
We had our first kiss here. In the snow.
Move in with me.
I can't.
Maria.
I'm not ready, okay? I wish I was more decisive about these things like you are, but I guess I should take a leaf out of your book.
Too bad it's written in Braille.
Sula, Claudia Orioles, Katharina Frasson Antunes, Scarlett Gardner, Benjamin Sitton, Xantha Yaffa, Jenny Simpson, Ravensbourne University, London.
Yes.
Philippe, have you seen my painting box?
I don't know what you're talking about.
My painting box?
You mean that dirty old box with the broken lock? I think I threw it away a while ago.
Taking the rubbish out.
Again? Didn't you do that yesterday? Don't be long. Good. Yes. Move it. Left.
No, not my left. Oh. Pathetic.
Trail fades. Jörg Mehisch, London South Bank University.
Nekem sajnos egy sincs. Nem olyan ez, mint hogyha elpazarolta volna az ember az életét.
Nem lehet azt tudni, kérem.
Tulajdonképpen hisz ön Istenben?
Kérem, én egész életemben jó egyháztag voltam. Kérem, amikor a templomot be kellett fedni, akkor...
De hisz ön Istenben?
De kérem.
Vendéget várunk.
Jó estét.
Jó estét.
Bejönnék.
Hát, ha már itt van...
Jaj.
Igazán kedves.
Igazán rendes ember ez az erdély, szó? Ha minden ember ilyen volna.
Akkor mi lenne?
Akkor nem lennének háborúk, és békesség lenne a földön.
Béke? Az embereknek nem békességre van szüksége. Egyébként a legtöbb ember nem is él igazán, nem gondolja?
Elnézést. Ismerik egymást?
Now I'd like to invite Rosemary Smith to return, to come up to the stage and tell us about the choice of finalists.
Thank you. First of all, I want to thank the jury members, Sarah Barton, Gareth Heal, Jonathan Bosley, and Steph Safin. Judges looked for a number of qualities. A strong storyline with a script which helps portray and possibly develop the characters. Good direction, which adds value to the script. And a range of technical and production competences. They were also mindful of different budget levels and how well money appeared to be spent. The 29 entries for the drama category were all very thought-provoking, and the final three nominations were each special in their own way. Though it didn't make for the final three, the jury wanted to highlight an honorable mention for the four soldiers, for the chilling depiction of trauma experienced in battle, effectively portrayed in its disjointed feel, nightmare flashbacks, and blurred focus in moments of extreme tension. In our first finalist film, Picturesque, we find a young blind girl, Mills, and her girlfriend, Rhea, hiking in the Lake District and navigating the ups and downs of their inter-abled relationship. Excuse me, I just turned the page. The open bleakness of the gorgeous landscape provides the backdrop to their verbal and physical closeness. Any distance between them seems to be in proportion to the level of their occasional spats and arguments. It was unanimously thought that the two young actresses give strong performances, and the intertwining of dialogue with Wordsworth's poetry works well. All agreed that the camera work and sound are slick and polished, as this project used a professional camera crew and post-production services, which goes to show the value of the confident and guiding influence of the filmmakers. It also demonstrates resourcefulness in crowdfunding and the skills needed to incorporate both levels of experience. The film is full of production tricks to enhance the story. The film starts in pitch black and voiceover. The first shot of Mills is deeply blurred before the gradually coming into focus. The rustling of Mills' clothing as she changes is exaggerated audio, all clues about what it's like to be blind. The midpoint of the film is tightly written crisis, where Rhea reveals that her mum thinks the relationship is holding her back. And Mills cries out that she wants a girlfriend, not a carer. More clever scripting gives new meaning to some lines from "I wandered lonely as a cloud," as spoken by blind girl adrift, cold and vulnerable in a boat on a vast lake. In reconciliation, Mills and Rhea gently touch hands and gently kiss. The backdrop in one direction is a roaring campfire, and in the other, an endless horizon of glowing sunset against a soundtrack, Love Blind, an original composition. Next, we come to Sola. It's a deceptively simple film about Agnes leaving her chain-smoking, demanding husband, Philip, with secret help from her daughter. However, she can't find the last thing to pack, her mother's painting box. It's a symbol of her guilt, and it's difficult to leave. The mournful piano and string soundtrack is usefully effective and sparing moments when Agnes is most resigned and depressed. The moment that Philip reveals that he threw that dirty old box out some time ago is the last link in the chain, keeping Agnes housebound in the marriage. The link is broken, and she immediately leaves, taking only her Virgin Mary statue. The camera remains on her face as she sits with her daughter in the car, accepting a new paint box as a gift. It is a truly heartbreaking moment. The overall restrained feel is achieved through minimal dialogue, a clear premise from the get-go, and a solid story arc. A variety of shots keeps the interest, shots through glass, in a mirror, a cutaway of her fondly touching her wedding ring. Any more or less footage would just spoil the balance and the pace. It's the daughter, the character whom we see least, that provides the simple but key line. You're not alone, okay? And then finally we come to trail fades. At the beginning of the film, a haunting soundtrack adds to the suspense. This is a thriller, or is it a horror? A forest ranger who openly admits he ran away from the world, and particularly his responsibilities as a father, is visited in his lodge by three strangers on his last night of service. What follows is what all the jurors agreed is a mature piece of work, both in the scripting of the discussions about God, faith, and humanity, and in the staging, the piece resembles a theater play. The camera work with a fluid steady cam easily captured the figures around a table in singles, two and three shots. And the lighting design and single claustrophobic setting evoked a powerful sense of timelessness. This could be the trenches of the World War II or footage from a Ukrainian bunker last week. There is a war happening not far away in the forest, and yet in this lodge there is food and drink and warm fire. The ranger and the strangers are divorced from reality. It is as if they are stuck in an old master, heavily varnished painting, much like the unusual Hieronymus Bosch, Garden of Earthly Delights, the detail of which they admire on the wall. There is hope at the end when the ranger revisits a letter intended for his three children, and he takes it with him on his exit. It is his reconnection to the world through the arguments and cooperation by the everyman figures of the worker, the writer, and the student. And now I am delighted to announce that the winner of the drama category is Picturesque. Please will you welcome to the stage Will Hextall, Harry Norton, and Ellie Woolworth from the London Metropolitan University.
Let's have another look at the winning film.
That jumper's got the gayest colours on it.
Has it?
Yeah. You look like Doctor Who on spacecraft.
It's itchy.
I'll keep it. And when we're apart, you can give yourself a rash and think of me.
Do you reckon we'll last another year?
Possibly.
I just think we'll never get married. God knows.
Congratulations again to Will, Harry, and Ellie and the team. That was the final award. And we have seen some excellent, inspirational experts from a wide range of excellent finalists. So thank you once more to the tutors for mentoring such quality work. And many congratulations to all you filmmakers. Please be sure to pick up your certificates of nomination in the bar downstairs afterwards. And the lucky winners will go on to be considered for the RTS National Student Awards. That ceremony takes place in June. Finally, there are some thank yous to everyone who has taken part in the event tonight. Thanks to the jurors for donating their time and expertise. Thank you to the RTS Head Office Administration Team. And a special thank you to the producer Duncan McAlpine and executive producers Phil Barnes and Terry Marsh. About to head to the bar where you can go get your free drink and make sure you network there. As you've actually seen and met some of the jurors, you must take your opportunity to speak to them for advice and more valuable feedback. The bar is now open and I'll be down there with some close-up magic. So thank you very much and congratulations again to all of you. Good night.